Sarah Rae. Welcome back to my channel and happy Def Leppard Saturday. If you are new here, this is Def Leppard Saturday, where we check out Def Leppard's catalog. We are up to Adrenalize, which means we have done their first album up to now. So that includes Pyromania, High and Dry, and Hysteria. All is in a playlist that will be linked in the description box down below. Now, we are around almost halfway through the album, so that means today we are checking out Stand Up, Kick Love Into Motion, and Personal Property. I'm excited to see what they bring to the table today because it's about half and half. It's been good so far, but also there's been some disappointments. So you definitely feel the loss though in Steve Clark with this record. And I'm curious to see how they handle themselves in the rest of the album. So, let's quit talking. You know the drill. Like, comment, subscribe. Hit the bell for notifications of when I upload. And let's check out these two songs. Alright, so our first one we're checking out is Stand Up, Kick Love Into Motion. Here we go.
I got to know right now. It's got to
stand up, kick love into motion. Let's start with the meaning of the song first before we really get into it. What I feel like the meaning of this song is exactly what the title says it to be. And I love when that happens. I feel like he's in a relationship where that physical side of it is missing. And he's like seeing that. He's looking that emptiness in her eyes and just wondering, why is this missing? Like, you know, let's just stand up and be a man and a woman and let's kick love into motion and let's just bring that part of us back. It doesn't have to be this way. And that's beautiful. It's exactly what the title says it to be. And that's what I think this song is saying. And as always, I'd love to hear what you think this song is about. Leave it in the comment section down below. Now, the song itself, oh, I thought it was beautiful. Oh. It has this more pop sounding to it, and it sounds a lot to me like Hysteria does. I don't know about you, but it kind of really reminds me of Hysteria. And it has that Hysteria album sound, almost like it, to me, belonged on Hysteria, and it doesn't exactly belong on this album. And to me, it doesn't kind of go with the overall theme of this album, but I mean, it's a nice change of pace and sound. I think it more suits Hysteria than this album, but it's beautiful, and I feel like it really has this mellow verses with this big catchy chorus that is beautiful, that really grabs you. And rock does that. Like, they have a way of speaking to you, and I've said this probably in every video, that rock can do that to you, speak to you through every part of a song, the instruments, the vocals, the lyrics, the production, everything, every aspect of the song. And this does it, you know. Def Leppard has a way of just physically making you react to a song, like Hysteria for me does, and so does Love Bites. Like, just makes me physically react, and I'm always looking for the next song that makes me feel that way, and this song right here gives me that feeling where I feel it, like, in every aspect of this song. I feel it. Oh, it is just remarkable. And the guitar solo sounds so much like Steve, and it's not over the top. It's very beautiful and really perfect for the song. I also love the little reference in here thrown to Led Zeppelin, Stairway to Heaven. I don't know if that's on purpose, but I feel like if the song is written by Steve, then it's definitely a reference thrown to Led Zeppelin on purpose, and I could see that being, if I had to guess, he's just on that line alone, I'm gonna bet you guys he is one of the writers on this song. I'm gonna bet you right now. Just on that line alone. I'd have to look up and pull up the lyrics. I don't have the lyrics pulled up right now, but because of that line alone. but it's such a great song, catchy verse, just a perfect well-rounded song. But again, it's more pop for them than it is that rock gritty sound that we're used to hearing from them. So, but I still think it's a gem. Beautiful. Now, I think I'll stop talking about it because I probably could go on. Let's dive right on to Personal Property. Let's see what we can get from Personal Property.
We'll be right back.
Yes, name that cat. Give it a name. That's our special YouTube family cat. I'm declaring it now. Well, I said it a long time ago, but you guys gotta give it a name. So personal property. Let's start with what I feel like this song is about. I feel like it is about, well, kind of self-explanatory, really, again. He is with this girl who he feels like is the most amazing woman ever, and she's personal property. She's his, nobody else's. And he explains in the song why he feels that way. So that's what I feel like this song is about. As always, let me know what you think this song is about, if it's different from mine, and leave it in the comment section down below. Now, onto the song itself. I know I didn't jam out as hard as I usually do, but I'm gonna tell you right now, I do absolutely love this song. The reason I didn't jam out was because I felt like, and I don't know if you guys will agree with me or not on this, but the song almost doesn't sound like Def Leppard. It sounds like, and this sucks because throughout the whole song, and after I turned off the camera and listened to it a second time with the lyrics, I couldn't put my finger on what band I'm thinking of, or the song that it sounds like, but this song reminds me of another song I've heard before and that I really enjoy, as well as the band that goes along with that song. It's just, it reminds me of something. It doesn't sound like Def Leppard. I don't know, that is probably, I don't know, a good thing. That means you can't pigeonhole Def Leppard. But Def Leppard has a certain sound to them, whether they are doing their most grittiest rock and roll, balls to the wall sound like you heard in their very first album and in High and Dry, or their pop sound, rock pop sound in Hysteria. They still have this sound to them. And in this song, you almost really don't hear it. And at first I was thinking maybe Bon Jovi, but then it doesn't exactly have Richie Sambora's guitar work. And it was like, oh, there, it's something. I can't lay my hand on it what band and song I'm thinking of. But if you feel that way and you are thinking of a band or song, leave it in the comment section down below. Because it is driving me nuts. Now, but as for the song itself, it has some great bones to it, some great guitar work throughout the song. I feel like it's very catchy, especially once he hits that very first time he sings Personal Property. I feel like that is really catchy, and that's when it first, I feel like, really draws you in. At first you're like, okay, this isn't too bad, but then he hits Personal Property. What's the lyrics here? He sings, "Loser's gonna weep, she's personal property." Once he hits that, you're hooked. It's like he just grabbed you and that's it. You're hooked into the song. And it's just very catchy. The chorus, you're just sitting there and you just get this smile on your face and you're just like, yeah, they did that. The way they did the chorus, the way Joe did the chorus was just great. I feel like Joe's vocals on this song in particular are so strong. I mean, in other songs on this album, you hear a variety of tones. He goes kind of low, he goes kind of high, but in this one, he's just doing this really strong vocals throughout the whole song, and it stays very consistent, very beautiful, and you really get a showcase of that strong vocal in his voice. Very beautiful. Very well-rounded song. I feel like they could have went a little more heavier on the guitar solo, but I think either way, the guitar solo they had in the song is perfect as well. I think it really wouldn't make a difference. I feel like this song as a whole could have been put out as a single in the 80s, and I know this is on the heels of the 80s, this was like 92. I think if it was released in the maybe late 80s as a single, it would have been probably this big hit, because this is what I feel like a pop rock single should sound like. It has everything to it. It's beautiful. I still think that, oh, I don't know. I still think it don't exactly sound like Def Leppard, but I think that might be a good thing, because then you can't pigeonhole them and know exactly how they sound, but I don't know. It still sounds amazing, and I think it's an underrated song. Very beautiful. I really enjoyed this one. Alright, so future me, I'm editing this video and listening to Personal Property again. I feel like there's just one thing missing in this song. And honestly, that's a really strong and notable rift that you can really follow. And I think that would have came from Steve had he been here to give that. You know what I mean? Because listen back to it, I feel like the guitar work is just a tad bit bland. It's still phenomenal and exactly what you'd want to hear from a pop rock single. Minus that edgier, notable guitar rift. You know, kind of like on Pyromania, songs like Rock, Rock Till You Drop, or Don't Shoot Shotgun. Songs like those. You know, that really noted rift. I still stand by, if this song was released in the 80s, it definitely would have been a hit. But I believe if you would have had Steve there, had he been there, I think there would have been a great riff to this song that would have gave it that perfect something to it, and it would have been perfection. Does that make sense? I hope I didn't just completely go against everything I said, but that's something I just kind of thought of. So, but it's still a phenomenal song, very well-rounded, great bones, everything. Just lacking that really noted rift. I feel like the guitar kind of gets lost a little bit. But that's it. So the overview. I absolutely adore these two songs. I think they were incredible. They definitely make up for that trash of a song. Make Love Like a Man. You guys, that song. But these two songs truly make up for that. You know, something that's difficult when it comes to reviewing albums is, you know, you know the songs that are big, right? And the huge singles. But albums have a few singles, and when it comes to something like say this album, like I know, Let's Get Rocked, and obviously I've listened to White Lightning, but I don't think White Lightning was a single, but pretty sure Let's Get Rocked was. But I'm sure there was much more singles than just Let's Get Rocked. So when it comes to like these two songs, I don't know if one of them were a single. I hope so. I hope both of them were, because I think they definitely deserve that. So when it comes to saying things like they're underrated is hard, because maybe they weren't. You know what I mean? So if they weren't singles, they needed to be. If they weren't singles, they were definitely underrated and are hidden gems. I think I'm going to say that as vague as that, like, and leave it like that. They had just great everything about them. Both of them did. Every little aspect of each of these two songs were beautiful, and I applaud them for it, especially with not having Steve there. To have a few of these songs that come out as good as like this song and what was the other song, Tonight. So Tonight, Stand Up, and Personal Property. To have like these three songs, and of course White Lightning, without Steve is definitely incredible in itself, because they turned out great and very touching and beautiful. So and very strong. So, and before I end this part of the video and we get to the end, I do want to say a thought that I'm having thinking about the album so far, since we have 3 songs left. You know, there's, so far I'm noting a kind of lack of cohesion in this album. Unlike the past 3, even 4 albums, even their debut album had a flow to it. And definitely, of course, their big 3 in the 80s obviously had a great flow to the albums. This album is different, though. I feel like there's songs that sound more like they should go on a different record, or they just don't blend right where they are, and it just seems all over the place. So, I don't know, we'll have to see what the rest of the album looks like. Maybe I'm just over analyzing, but so far that's what I'm seeing from this album so far. Let me know if you guys get that too, and I'm not just the only one. But that I just wanted to put that out there, let you guys know that's what I'm seeing from this album. Now, before I go, we have one last thing to talk about, and that is what we're doing once this album is done. As you guys know, I had said we are going to do a different band, and we're going to do 4 albums. I want to see who you guys want to see next, by you guys commenting who you want to see next. Start thinking, start commenting, let me know. And whatever artist or band is requested the most or has the most tallied is going to be next. But as of right now, there's no artist that has been requested the most or tallied the most. It's just different artists are being thrown out right now, but these are the artists that are being thrown out so far: AC/DC, The Cars, Aerosmith, Queen, and Motorhead. Let me know if any of those sound good to you guys, or if you guys want to see somebody else other than that, leave it in the comment section down below. But it's up to you guys, so let me know. The band that has the most requests gets the vote. So, that description of what I just said will be in the description box down below, but guys, comment who you want to see next. It's all up to you. I don't want to have to pick in the end. So, start commenting. Now, with that said, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you guys are staying safe and well. And I'll see you guys in the next video.